Hey there! Welcome to the HP Workbench video series. I'm Steph, and today I want to talk about the right memory for upgrading your computer. Do you want your computer to run faster? Have you ever been frustrated with lag time when you're gaming or editing pictures and videos? Then it might be time to upgrade your memory. Increasing your computer's memory is an affordable, easy, and noticeable upgrade that you can do yourself. This video is part of our HP Workbench series that covers selecting and installing memory. I'm going to talk about some basic information on memory, like size, type, and speed, to help you with your selection. Of course, once you learn how much and what type of memory you need, you're going to need to install it. Installing memory is easy, but first, make sure to check out our other videos in this series for all the details on installation, to make sure you're comfortable with the whole process. All right, so first off, memory is also known as RAM. RAM stands for Random Access Memory. Here, we have some examples of what different types of modules look like. These modules are what make up your PC's RAM. Modules easily fit into your motherboard, just like this. Motherboards typically have 2, 4, 6, or 8 slots to install RAM. It's important to know that all the slots don't need to be filled up to function properly, but they can be. We'll talk more about that in a bit. Now, modules come in different sizes. The most common sizes are 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, and even 32 gigabytes. To find out what your total system memory is, you'll need to add the size of each module together. So, for example, if you have 2 4 gigabyte modules installed, you'd add those together and your total system memory would be 8 gigabytes. Pretty simple, right? Now, let's talk about memory types. There are a few different types of memory you should be aware of. Different types of memory aren't interchangeable, so it's important to know what type you have so you know what type to get. First, we have SODIMMs. SODIMMs are smaller memory modules used in notebooks and HP Touch smart computers. Then, there are DDR2s, DDR3s, and DDR4s. DDR2 modules can be found in older PCs and aren't commonly used anymore. DDR3 and DDR4 are the modules that you usually find on more modern PCs. Now, if we compare a DDR3 to DDR4, you'll see that these notches don't line up. You can't use different types of memory at the same time. DDR4 modules won't work with DDR3. So, it's important to do some research about your own setup before you upgrade. When shopping for memory, you'll find modules come with different speeds. It is possible to mix modules with different speeds together, but the computer will only go as fast as the slowest speed. It's also important to be aware of your motherboard's speed. Your memory will never run faster than the capability of the motherboard. In most cases, having a larger memory size is more important than having the fastest speed. Dual, triple, and quad channel are modes used to double, triple, or quadruple the speed the RAM communicates with the CPU. These modes increase the number of channels used between the memory controller and the memory, allowing for faster data transfer. For example, a base model PC that's used for email and web browsing usually comes with a dual channel configuration, whereas a high performance gaming PC might come with a quad channel configuration. To find out what your system is set up for, you can look at your computer's documentation or you'll see it labeled directly on your motherboard. Some motherboards are even color-coded for easy installation. It's also important to mention that you'll want to install new RAM in exact pairs for best results. That means that the modules are the same size, speed, and from the same manufacturer. Most manufacturers make this easy and bundle modules together to buy as a kit. So now you might be wondering, how much memory can I add? Well, to answer that, you must first understand a few limitations. One limitation is your motherboard. Some motherboards have a limit on the size and capacity of memory it can handle. So using a 16 gigabyte module might not work if your system doesn't support that amount of memory. Check your computer's documentation to find out what your motherboard can handle. Another limitation is your computer's operating system. 32-bit versions of Windows 10 can use up to 4 gigabytes, but 64-bit versions of Windows 10 can handle more, up to 2 terabytes, depending on which version of Windows 10 you are using. Next, you will want to determine how much memory you need. Upgrading your RAM is always a good idea, but to find out how much RAM you need to ask yourself, what do I use a computer for? Most PCs come with at least 2 gigabytes of RAM. That amount allows you to do some basic documentation work and some light web browsing. 4 to 8 gigabytes would be better for some multi-tab web browsing, media streaming, and some light photo editing and gaming. Bumping it up to 16 to 32 gigabytes would let you do all these things, plus make video editing and graphic-intensive gaming run more smoothly. Upgrading your PC's memory is an easy and affordable upgrade. If your system can handle it, and depending on what you want it for, upgrading will make a more enjoyable experience. Well, I hope today was informative and that we've helped you make a decision about upgrading your memory. Make sure to check out our other videos in the HP Workbench series for more information about memory and installation.